who's been, you know, who's just been destroying tournament after tournament ever since the lockdown ended. Let's see who's gonna take it home. Game number one of Inkling versus Samus on Battlefield.
Battlefield, surprisingly enough, again, this is such a difficult stage against Samus.
Yeah, Space always bans this stage.
Yeah, but as, again, especially against Samus with the up B being so difficult to punish here.
For
it
sure.
It is a kind of a interesting stage pick, to say the least. But maybe Space has something figured out that he wants to abuse versus Siski. But right now, most of the time, it has been Siski taking or giving most of the hits, but Space, and they're looking good, getting an early roller in. It's not going to lead to an KO, but another extension of the advantage state.
And look at this, the juggle is so real. Inkling not known for juggling, but Space making the best of it, and the chase with the boots off stage and an early lead. Like you said, Siski, you know, took the momentum, but as soon as Space got a single hit, that floatiness that Samus has really came to bite Siski in the behind, and right now, Space is looking strong.
And there goes the trigger happy upbeats from Siski are his trademark, kinda. But they can be punished, especially like a character like Inkling who can get something really big out of that. Ink you for half or maybe full if you miss that. And you see the lead trap coming in, crouch cheering on, but Space escaping them so elegantly. Try not anything, no any trouble for inside. He's gonna get the
double back air. Nice pressure, Siski. Going all out for that KO, and again, going all out for that KO with the char shot, finding a nice sequence of reads right there. And now, Space, of course, using that invincibility, getting a little bit of a punish, but the platforms are gonna let Siski just get out very easily. Upper, up B, not gonna be very punishable, and even extending the advantage because of the platforms. And you have to wonder, the Battlefield pick, what is the meaning behind it? Space always talks about how this is probably his least favorite stage as Inkling, right? And so far, I think in terms of advantage, we can see how dominant Siski is using those platforms to not just extend, but also also disengage if it's looking dicey.
Yeah, and it doesn't also help that this is arguably one of Samus' best stages as well.
Yep.
He has been showing that between his platforms is super hard to get down there. It's kind of, you need to be very careful once you're moving down to not get caught by Siski. Back for it's gonna send Space up the ledge, 93% on Siski, 140 here on Space.
Goodness.
And the charge shot is gonna take the stock on the neutral getup. Space looking a little bit less confident than at the start of this game.
He had a huge, huge burst of momentum, but it's all but gone now as Siski is really finding his stride. Really finding the right hits. The up B for the defense. The ledge trap is back online. The pressure is back online. Siski using the homing missile as well. He's pulling everything out of the books.
He's pulling out all the stops to make sure that this Inkling does not get any opening, because she hasn't actually been able to punish Siski or get an opening in for at least an entire stock. Gets the Zarian. It's not going to take a stock. Extra damage to add to the count. Now Space finally being back in the center stage. Might try something,
goodness,
but the up B is going to interrupt immediately again.
Those platforms are so good for Samus. Normally, she kind of suffers from her floaty jump, right? But on the platform, she does not have to go up. She can only go down. And then the landing aspect of her nair, of her Becker, are amazing. And the char shot is going to finish it off. Siski with a solid, solid two-stock, showing how much of a struggle this matchup can really be if the Samus just plays that cool, calm, collected, methodical game plan.
Exactly.
And Space, you know, like we mentioned, had that nice bit of momentum. But Siski, you know, he started landing to the platform, started using B-reverse, started using that movement, and it was so hard for Space to do anything about that.
Exactly. Except when Siski got control of basically every platform, Inkling couldn't really do anything. Space kind of struggled to get something going, and then Siski, so good sticking to his game plan, that effective, simple game plan, or it's not as simple as you would think it is, but it's still, it's straightforward.
It's methodical.
It's super straightforward, but methodical.
Yeah.
And he stuck to it like a book, and it worked perfectly.
I mean, both of these players are surgeons.
Exactly.
Right? Like, Space, very methodical, very step-by-step Inkling player, very surgical in his approach. Siski, exactly the same.
Exactly.
He goes for what works, and it worked well. Let's see if Small Battlefield offers any respite for Space, or if it's going to be Siski just continuing to honestly dominate this matchup.
We may have lost the top of the stage this time, but we're going to see how that is going to work out for Space. We already see, just going for down air.
The reset,
that is such a confident sign of play, going for the reset instantly there. Siski is not as scared as he was in the first stock, and he is just trying to catch Space out. Now he gets hit by a good forward air there, catching him out. So much damage coming in. Another forward air.
Hey, this is looking like game one, man.
Yeah.
The pressure is real, but this time Siski finding some more breaks in the pressure, using the wave dash to land on the platform, actually. Using, you know, counteracting a bit of that floatiness. The double hit in air forces a reaction. Siski is hunting. He's chasing. He's looking for a roll in with the down air, too, and he's almost found it as well. Space looking for those backers. They look to be good zone breakers. It's hard for Siski to counteract them on reaction as they get the Zairs. And now the chase is real. But the bombs and the footstool, all Siski needs.
Oh, that was such a flexible recovery to get out of there. So well played
from
Siski. Up air.
Not a KO. He was kissing the blast zone.
Yeah, but it is still Samus being a fairly heavy character. Going to survive that until a bit more. Now with a 31% space
Siski.
As much out because he has been getting caught by those charge shots in game number one.
Siski is starting to turn a little bit more call-out heavy, I feel like. The up smash call-out, the forward air call-out. I wonder how Space is going to, like the grab call-out there. I wonder how Space is going to change in reaction to this change by Siski. The grab call-out again. Nice. So that's what Space is doing. He's waiting more, right? Mm. Waiting for the call-out to happen, and then he acts. The roll gets scouted out by the charge shot, and the jump gets red. Siski just so precise with those forwarders.
Yeah, if Samus is in that position, you really can permit yourself to use that double jump. For sure, it's going to get sniped. Now Space trying to go far off stage and gimping in with the up B, but suddenly it doesn't work out.
Oh my god, the single hit up air?
The single hit up air in there and charge shot instantly doing 47% and surviving that up smash still.
Yeah, the weak hit on that is not going to do much. Space getting the short end of a lot of these interactions, but the back air, that's a big break in his favor. 73, of course, not a comfortable disadvantage to have, but at the same time, we've seen how much damage Space can do with a single hit. He's looking for it. We see the dash dances. That means he's looking for the grab, but the charge shot is keeping him out. Siski, just so confident being in the corner, gets called out by the jab, though. Only 16, but a good bit of ink, and that's going to mean the up air. Up air is big. Almost 50 already, 60 already on Siski. The jab mix up. What is Siski going to do? Just grab.
Just grab him, man.
Yep.
It's worth it. He's going to try and throw it. The forward actually going to the charge up. This is going to help. Instant up B going to send Space upwards.
Nice.
And getting him caught in another forward there. Now Space has to survive this last trip. Does it beautifully. Almost gets hit by the reverse charge up.
Oh, grab.
But Space being, as you said, a bit more patient,
oh, no.
A bit more weighty.
Yeah, he's going to make that. He's going to make the bomb actually tagged him. The uppy was an attempt by Siski, another attempt, both unpunished. Space, he's a little bit out of it, it seems like. But talking about out of it, that grab definitely did not connect. Space out of the range of that move. The up throw, nice. Siski.
Nice play. I think he wanted to get the space, wanted to get the roll read, but just kind of mispaced that. There's no reason for Samus to roll into that ledge there. Backer actually sniping her from there. No double jump, I think.
No double jump and Space making great use of that opportunity. Just scouting out the air to ledge with the down tilt. Very active, that down tilt. And the charge shot barely missing.
But that forward air.
Oh my god, those uppies need to get punished. Come on, Space.
Yeah.
You can do this. Now we got the combo, no double jump for Siski. Big momentum shift. We talked about this before, right?
Still no double
jump. The combo damage from Inkling can be insane if he finds the right extension. And Space did right there. It breaks through the charge shot charge as well. Just calls him out, shows, hey, I'm willing to do this. And Siski misjudging the air dodge. And that is Space showing he's not out of this yet. And this is a lot of what we talked about, right? Where Siski is a different type of Samus. So the way that you bring your experience to the table is often a little bit more reactive.
Yeah.
Where at first you got to figure out, hey, how does your Samus work in the first place? And then when you know that, you can apply that knowledge. And that's what we're seeing from Space right now. Of course, losing gives you more information than winning. So now Siski having a little bit of, a lot of data to work with, right?
Exactly. I think one thing that also kind of didn't work in Siski's favor is at the beginning we said he was really feeling himself, going for the callouts, and even the second stock he was really going for it, and they didn't work out. It cost him a lot of percentage in the stage presence, but right now we're going to go to Smashville, just a smaller sized stage. Let's see how both these players are going to turn it out. 1-1 currently in the losers quarterfinals.
We got the up air, but no confirmation. The run up jab, that can be so hard to see. Space just mixing up his options. The grab connected into the ink bomb and a punish on the uppy. Hallelujah, Space. Okay,
yeah,
I mean, one out of two. That's a better ratio than we've seen before.
It's an attempt. It is getting there. Tries to get the latch trap. Does get it. Oh, okay, no tech there.
Oh.
Okay, just mash the uppy. That's fine. It's fine. You can get out of there.
Baits the charge shot. Makes it whiff. Gets caught on the jump, though. Siski, nice conversion. Space just jumping, ignoring the ledge, just jumping to the center, right?
Yeah.
Making sure he does not get ledge trapped. Siski so patient with those up B's on the other hand. So we really have both of these players now kind of adjusting their play to mostly play around the opponent's strong tools, right? Mm-hmm. So Space ignoring the ledge trap, instead jumping over to avoid Samsa's strong ledge traps. Meanwhile, Siski playing a little bit more shield heavy so he can get those reactions. Talking about playing around the opponent, Space making great use of that floatiness, catches the landing.
Yeah.
Very rare occurrence against a character like Samus, right?
Yeah, there's a lot of window to get him caught with that roller, catching him with the fourth smash. Oh, almost the fourth! The charge shot himself, now another electric trap that Space has to survive. Again, jumps over it, and it keeps working out, but there's going to be a point where there's going to be a charge shot in his face at that point. No double jump for Space, but makes it out alive.
Siski's down airs are insane.
Yeah.
How often he knows when the opponent wants to roll in and just hard punches it with the down air. Like, he's psychic or something. I don't know how he does it, but he keeps doing it. Siski has to find the stock, though. Just reading a roll is not enough if you don't get the final hit. And there it is, the final hit of the forward air.
Sniped
him, actually.
Hitting
the ledge.
Yeah. Great.
Space sleeping.
There was such a good positioning there for Siski.
I mean, it makes sense, right? Because what we talked about before, you know, Siski, really going for those preemptive callouts, and Space has started to wait. And this time, Siski's saying, hey, you cannot wait for me.
No.
I'm going to call it up.
He's putting up the pressure to maybe get something going. He does get most of the time, and now those upbeats are going to be prevalent. It is going to be Siski who has to control of the stage for the most part now, catching him with the anti-air.
Jab, jab, jab. Big damage. And the ink as well. We've seen the damage that ink can lead to. Back air to forward air. It's all but guaranteed. Tries to catch the Zare. Doesn't quite get it.
Yeah, doesn't quite get it there.
Ooh.
So he gets back to the stage. Charge shot on parry. Still going to be punished by Siski with the up B. Tries to go for another downer there, as you said.
Ooh.
Oh, but jumps over the charge shot yet again. And there is going to be one point where
they're
going to get caught out.
They're just scrapping. You can see it. The up B, that means he's scrapping. And the side B just calling things out left and right, but they're not hitting each other. The grab does not connect, and Siski gets the better end of this scramble. And the left shot gets charged up. Inklings jump high enough to go over the fair.
But also, Siski doesn't usually have a full charge shot at this point.
True.
Usually has a small one, maybe a medium. So that ledge trip becomes a lot less scary if you're just going to get hit by the bomb. But that neutral air is going to send him out of there.
After whiffing the up B, actually reversing the situation into a landing nair. Siski pushing so far, and Space not keeping up here.
He's going to try and get that stuff out of there.
Oh my goodness, the grab. Oh, Siski's just making the callouts. Space needs to make something happen here. Nice, the dash grab is a good start.
Not going to go for the up for upper. Saw that didn't work out and gets him with the backer on the bomb.
Can I just highlight how good Space is at gimping Siski?
Yeah.
He's getting most of his KOs through those offstage interactions. Samus is not easy to gimp. She has a Zare, she has an up B, she has her down B too. But Space finds those hits. Now Siski in a neutral though, looking very, very strong.
Has
chasing
that
down.
Shot. That's a big number on Space's counter right there. Still doesn't have a charge up, but the
goodness.
Jump is finally going to get caught out with the up tilt at the precise timing he needs to.
Siski was looking for that.
He was really looking. To be fair, Space has been doing it for most of the game.
So yeah, he's been
really
jumping over the fairs, right?
Yeah.
Yep. So the up tilt coming in big for Siski. I can hardly hear you because the... Yo, 2,000
Yo,
battles,
we got him!
So, in that sense, really interested to see what Space is going to put on the table here.
Yeah.
Because we've seen that he has it in him. But the biggest thing really is like the neutral control.
Yeah.
Like Siski has been controlling the neutral. In the second game, we kind of saw Space compensate for that by getting big punishes.
Exactly.
But those haven't landed in this game.
Yeah.
So it's really about like, you know, Siski, can he dominate and chip? Or can Space find that break he needs and really destroy Samus from the inside out once he gets that hit? Let's see, game number four. This is going to be Space. Space's tournament life. He's fighting for his bracket spot, I should say. The bomb negating the jab. I've never seen that before.
Yeah, it is a high-stakes match for Siski. The second seed in the tournament is expected to make it out alive, but Space still such a titan of an opponent.
Ooh.
Catches him actually with the grab. The max range of that grab. And as you said, it is usually Siski taking a neutral, but that means that Space has to kind of get out of his comfort zone and play a more risky, aggressive game against someone who actually gets to play their own game at this point.
He's forcing Space to make callouts, and Space did it right there with the getup attack. It worked out well, but it's not. Look at the damage difference, bro. It's not working out. Space cannot get the grab on that Nair either. The two hits are so safe, and the forward air is not going to connect, but Space has to land somehow. Siski, he's looking for it, makes a call out, and the call out comes through.
Yeah, that charge shield putting in the work, almost a full one killing across the stage is going to be enough. Siski still sitting quite healthy
at 90. Offstage is rough. Oh, but Siski maneuvering very well, and those are the interactions that matter the most, right? Does he make it back? Can he punish the up B? That is the name of the game, and they're both struggling, right? Like, Siski struggling to recover, Space struggling to punish consistently.
Jump.
And look at the mix of Siski throwing out the air dodge. Haven't seen that a lot yet. Space, you can see that he's looking a little bit harder off stage because he knows he needs the gimps, right?
Yeah, that's where he gets most of his success.
Yep, and again, looking a little bit harder, and Siski answering right back. The rage is going to be in effect here. This is not going to be easy. I don't know how that did not cover the normal getup, but Siski, again, he recovers, tries to get a cheeky down air. Not going to work out.
Okay, now off stage, Space Shines gets the backer. No double jump from Siski. This should be a dead Samus.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. 72. What do you think, Dajo? 72.
72. It should be possible if he gets inked like that. The inkling combos will get a lot of damage in, and it gets a grab, and it's big.
Nair, okay. But doesn't confirm, and a charge shot from the platform. Again, those platforms so huge for Samus, and the up comes through. Siski covers and covers and covers.
Yeah, it kind of the preemptive punish at Space once the front runner gets punished every single time by that up B. And it always surprises him how often he can throw it out and in what situation he can throw it out. Gets something going right now, but it's still not enough to match Siski's advantage state and neutral. Reads him to roll in and the neutral.
I told you about his reads on a roll in, man. I told you. And here he is being so consistent. That down smash.
He got it through it with the up B. Okay, then.
Yeah, he landed in the middle of the down smash. He landed in the middle.
Blind spot.
Stuck in the middle with you, and in this situation, not where you want to be. Gets a nice jet, but Space has to make some sort of play happen. The crowd cheering for Space, hoping for that last huzzah for that roller to hit, but the little morph ball going over it.
That hurt box shift is going to secure him, and this is looking dire for Space. Has to watch out, shark
it
shot.
Is.
And now up tilt is going to do the job, so he has to watch out for the jump
there
again or the ledge hang.
Is.
And Siski takes it. 3-1 over Space.
Space literally got crushed under the heels of Siski Samus, and he shows why he is one of the best that Europe has to offer. He shows why he was the second seed today, taking that victory over Space. A hard-fought battle, but honestly, I didn't expect any less from Siski.
No, it looked kind of good in Space's favor, especially after he got in, got a couple of good interactions, and
yep.
He took that game, but then
something clicked.
Something switched, and Siski was like, I'm just going to play my game.
Yep.
I'm going to play very carefully.
And he did
not
so.
Do anything stupid. And then at one point, Space is going to feel pressured, engage, do something stupid, and punish it.
The thing, you know, Siski is just, you know, he's in control, right?
Yeah,
he has a charge
shot.
He has the bombs as well for less shots, right? So, like, in all sorts of scenarios, he is the one who's going to win by chipping.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
That